Though the exterior architecture is somber, the dazzling magnificence of the interior of St. John's Co-Cathedral is nothing short of venerable. The vault of the church is decorated with paintings by the artist Marti Apreti and depicts episodes in the life of St. John the Baptist. Houses one of the most dramatic works of Caravaggio, the beheading of St. John, the only signed work by the master existing anywhere in the world. His St. Jerome lies just a few steps away. Here is the resting place of Europe's finest nobility who vied with each other to become members of the Order of St. John. Two blocks down Republic Street is the Palace of the Grand Masters, which is in itself one massive museum. Sit in the old council chamber and admire the beautiful Gobelin tapestries. Walk in the footsteps of the Grand Masters through long, imposing corridors. Admire the magnificence of the staterooms and the frescoes depicting scenes from the history of the Order of St. John. Then make your way to the Upper Baracca Gardens and get a splendid view of Malta's famous Grand Harbour, which today hosts an ever-increasing number of cruise liners. Close by is the outdoor market Il Monte, which has a magnetic attraction for visitors and locals alike. The island is a mecca for shoppers, where one can find locally made goods mingling with brands of world renown. Those with time to spare should digest the city's rich fare in several helpings. But Malta is not just history and shopping. Malta is fun. The waters around Malta and its islands are renowned as some of the most limpid in the Mediterranean. They are a real all-year-round paradise for divers and offer a fascinating underwater landscape.